Hi! In this short video, I'll show you how to perform a conflict check on your WordPress site. If you've never done this before, you might think this is too technical. And that's exactly why we made this video, to show you that it's not that difficult at all. Let's start with two basic questions. What is a conflict check? And why do we ask you to do it? Well, your WordPress installation consists of WordPress core, a theme, and plugins like Yoast SEO. Unfortunately, sometimes these aspects conflict with each other, and that might cause a problem. A conflict check can help you identify the cause of the problem, and it's the cause we need if we want to tackle the problem. If the conflict check shows that the problem is caused by our plugin, our developers will try to fix the bug. If it's caused by something else, other companies or support forums may be able to shed light on the issue. Okay, the fastest way to rule out conflicts is to deactivate all plugins and switch to a standard theme, like 2020. If this resolves the problem, you have indeed a conflict. Now, you should activate one plugin at a time until you locate the conflict. Once all plugins are active, switch to your theme. Whoa, wait a minute. You're telling me to deactivate plugins on my live site? How can I do that without affecting my visitors? Well, we highly recommend using the Help Check plugin. The troubleshooting mode of this plugin allows you to run a conflict check without affecting normal visitors. However, we understand if you're still a bit hesitant. It may be a good idea to set up a staging environment for your tests. You can ask your host to create one for you, or you can use a staging plugin, like WP Staging. Okay, let's get started. Let's say you've encountered a problem on your site. For example, Yoast SEO stops acting the way it's supposed to act. What's the first thing you should do? Check for updates. Click the Updates tab in the admin menu and make sure that you update your WordPress core installation, your plugins, and your themes to the latest version. So, let's do that. Done? Then you're ready for step 2. And we'll need the Health Check plugin for that. As you can see, I've already installed and activated the Health Check plugin. Now, let's go to the Tools tab in the admin menu and click Site Health. Then click the Troubleshooting tab. You can read here once more that by enabling the troubleshooting mode, all plugins will appear inactive and your site will switch to the default theme only for you. All other users will see your site as usual. So, let's enable. And now my site is in troubleshooting mode. As you can see here, my plugins are all inactive and the active theme is a default one, 2020. This one, called Natural Light, was activated before I enabled troubleshooting mode. Now, check whether the problem you've encountered is still there. If it is, your problem is not caused by any of your plugins or your theme. This may be a WordPress issue, a conflict with your specific setup, or something related to your server or your web host. That means that we are not able to help you with a solution. What you can do, however, is check the topics on the WordPress support forums. Does someone experience the same or a similar problem? It may help point you in the right direction. So, if the problem is still there, check the forums and don't forget to disable troubleshooting mode. If the problem is gone, it's caused by something else, which means that we need to continue the conflict check. Let's enable the Yoast SEO plugin. In our case, that's Yoast SEO Premium. Now, check for your problem again. If the issue occurs when Yoast SEO is the only active plugin, well, then you found your cause. What next? If you're using Yoast SEO Premium, you can contact us by email and we'll take care of it. If you're using Yoast SEO Free, you can file a bug report for our development team. We have this article on Yoast.com that explains how and where you can do that. And don't forget to disable troubleshooting mode. If you can't reproduce the problem in this setting, we need to continue. Now, you should enable your plugins one by one. We're looking for the minimum plugin environment required to reproduce the problem. So if you think the problem is related to Yoast SEO, make sure that you enable that plugin first. Then enable one of your other plugins. Check for the problem. Then disable the other plugin and enable another one. Then check for the problem. Repeat this until the issue occurs. If the issue occurs while both Yoast SEO and another plugin are enabled, you found the conflict. What next? Contact us if you're a premium user. File a bug report if you use Yoast SEO free. As it's a conflict with another plugin, two parties are involved. So don't forget to report the issue to the other team as well. The more people are aware of it, the sooner your problem can be tackled. Finally, if you don't find a plugin conflict, there could be a theme conflict. To find out whether that's the case, disable all plugins. Then switch to the theme you were using before you enabled troubleshooting mode. If you're using a child theme, then first test the parent theme. Check for the problem. If it's there, then there's an issue with your theme. Try to contact them. If nothing strange happens, enable Yoast SEO. Is there a conflict? Then you know what to do next. Contact us or file a bug report. And don't forget to inform the developers of the conflicting theme as well. Of course, it doesn't have to be Yoast SEO that conflicts. It could also be another plugin. If you can't find anything related to the parent theme, check your child theme and repeat the steps. It's not difficult, it just takes time. So, good luck!